Let's look at a transaction in which a fixed asset was purchased. I'm going to go to enter bills because the asset was purchased on account. I'm going to go back and find where we purchased the computers on account. Now when buying a fixed asset, use the expenses tab, not the items tab. The expenses tab allows you to choose any account, not just expenses. The tab shows the expenses label because expenses are the most frequently chosen accounts for this window. When recording the purchase of a fixed asset such as a computer, use the computer cost account. Do not use the computer's account. The computer's cost account is a sub account of the computer's account. The expenses tab will first show the parent account and then the sub account. If we open up the chart of accounts, we see that there are three accounts for computers. The computer's account is the parent account. It exists just to keep these two accounts, computer's cost and accumulated depreciation computers, side by side on the chart of accounts. We never assign anything directly to the computer's account. We also have the computer's cost account. When purchasing a computer, choose this account. Now if you accidentally chose the computer's account instead of computer's cost, just go back to the transaction and change it from computers to computer's cost. And of course, we also have the accumulated depreciation computers account. Obviously, choose this account when recording accumulated depreciation for the computers. Notice that the computer's cost account and accumulated depreciation accounts are indented. This is because these accounts are sub-accounts of the computer's account. Again, this computer's parent account only exists to keep these two accounts side by side on the chart of accounts. If you edit either the computer cost account or accumulated depreciation account, you'll notice that they are both sub-accounts of the computer's account. This is where we choose the parent account. If we turned off the sub-account and saved it, notice that computer's cost no longer falls directly under computers and it's no longer indented. Also notice that the accumulated depreciation computers account is listed as a type, this is the account type, of fixed asset. In Intro to Accounting, we learned that accumulated depreciation is actually a contra asset, not a fixed asset. But when creating a new account in QuickBooks, notice there is no type of account called contra asset. It's not listed here either. So when creating an accumulated depreciation account, we are forced to use the fixed asset type of account. And then later, when we record accumulated depreciation in it, we credit accumulated depreciation like we always do. But by crediting something that is a fixed asset, you're giving it a negative balance. The end effect of the negative balance in the accumulated depreciation is it starts to offset the overall value of the computer account as time goes by. So the $3,600 cost of the computer minus the accumulated depreciation gives you the asset's book value, $3,540.